And here are the pros. Richard Del Rosario. Jason Webb. And Mico Halili. Welcome to the Bro Show.
Eh, welcome bros! Uy, medyo ano pala, sexy pala nito shorts ko. Akala ko medyo mahaba na siya. Hindi, ginagaya ko lang sa bro. Ito lang shorts na dalawang beses niya eh.
Sa love?
So, sabi ko, sige, makapag-shorts ka. Anyway, it's a podcast. So, we can do anything. We can say anything, di ba?
Yeah, that's right.
Kailan tayo magkaya ka like inuman podcast? As in,
parang ano?
Ano?
Parang, ikaw naka-shorts. May meaning yan.
Ano meaning? Ano meaning?
Hindi, may styling ka ngayon. May kilala natin, styling rin.
Bakit?
Ano ba? Maganda ng t-shirt mo, bro.
Ah, ito ba?
Ganda.
Parang ano yun, no? Parang lagi na lang may ganito, eh.
Also, is it our first time to congratulate him on the bro
show?
Yeah,
of course.
Well, yeah,
of course.
Congrats, yeah. Bro.
Thanks, bro.
Philippine Cup champions.
Sorry, thanks again.
Back to back?
Back to back, ha?
Eh, baka naman sabihin nyo, nakakalimutan ko kayo.
Oh. Ah,
siyempre, meron akong dati, wine and cheese.
Oh, ayan, with the Philippine Cup trophy.
Yes. Ah.
With the same shirt?
With the same shirt. So, hindi pa yan. Kaya,
oh, nga, no?
May dug out pa. Hindi pa nalalaman.
Oh, number two.
So, anong dala? May dala ka?
Meron akong dala.
Anong dala mo? Anong dala mo for the bros?
Well, kasi sabi ko sa'yo, I was going to the Bahamas, right?
The Bahamas.
The Bahamas.
Yeah. Bahamas.
Yeah. So, sorry, nagko-coffee muna ako kasi may mga hangover pa,
may
bro.
Hangover ka pa.
But, you know what? I got you some Victory cigars. Baka you want?
Pwede ba tayo mag-cigars dito?
Hindi, wag mo sisindihan. Pero, at least, you
sa
know.
Sa Bahamas pala yung cigars. Akala ko sa Cuba eh.
Bakit ano?
Nag-stop over eh.
Parang, parang pretzel lang ang dating. Parang champola lang ang dating to, ah.
Parang nagtitipid ka.
Bro, oh, diba ang Victory cigar yung mataba? Alam diba, Cubano? Diba, ganun, diba?
Ba, ganyan lang yan, bro. Mga
pariyo, silang yung dating, oh.
Mga champion lang yung may ganito.
Yan na ang binigay sa inyo na cigar?
Ah? Anong binigay? Binili ko to, bro. Mahal to. Huwag niyo masyadong yan. Mahal
pero
yan,
pero mabango, ha?
Mango, ha?
Chocolate yan.
So, kakainin ko.
Hindi. Ano ko pa, hindi ko malang sisigar.
Mamaya. We'll,
sisindihan natin to mamaya.
Mamaya. Sisindihan natin to. Thanks, bro.
Thank you.
And congratulations to the San Mig Super Coffee Mixers for winning the Philippine Cup. Now,
walking away with the
champion.
Away with
Mayroon sila. Pero, okay. We did receive a lot of tweets. A lot
requests.
Of requests na magkaroon ulit ng champs episode because we had one.
Yes.
About right after the Governor's Cup.
That's right.
Now, can you explain why wala muna tayong champs episode this week?
Ay, kasi mga bros and mga babes at mga sponkies. Medyo yung players natin nag-ano muna, nag-konting break, nag-bakasyon. So, ang hirap silang ano eh, ma-invite ngayon dito dahil alam niyo naman, haba ng season, tapos start na naman ng panibagong season. So, medyo pagbigyan muna natin sila to enjoy. But we promise you, we will have that champs night again here in the Bro Show.
Because, you know, the players na gusto nyo, they're actually out of town.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yung mga players naman na ayaw nyo, yan, mag-ensayo.
kami yun.
Again, sayo.
Next. So, because we want to give you the best champs episode.
Uh-huh.
So, syempre, we want to get yung players na pinakagusto nyo. But since they're out of town, i-postpone muna natin, bro.
Mm-hmm.
Pa-postpone muna natin yung champs episode so that when we do it, you'll have the, you know, your favorite players.
Eh, hopefully, maisabay na natin sa Commissioner's Cup.
Yabang.
Dalawa pa yung isa nito.
Yabang.
Mabuhusan.
Sorry, lasing pa yata ako.
Pang Coms Cup na to.
Ang dami nito sa Cuba.
Sige, mamaya. Kung paano. You know, sino gusto kong abutan ngayon ng cigar? Today? LeBron James.
LeBron
Red Alert. And you know, and
sa ngayon?
61?
Hindi, hindi Red Alert.
Hindi, ibang Red Alert yun. Iba yun.
Hindi yun.
Hindi yun. Walang Red Sea. Iba yun. Red Alert kasi, ang init niya this morning. Wow. I mean, 61 points for LeBron James.
61 points, career high. And I'm surprised. Akala ko yung naka-60 na siya dati. First time pala to reach 61. 61, no?
Against sino ba kalaban?
Ang lakas ng kalaban.
Sino?
The Bobcats.
The Bobcats.
The Bobcats.
Ano yun?
Well, apparently, they're supposed to be a very, you know, a potent defensive team. Mm-hmm. And yet, he scored the 61 points.
Hindi, pero kasi si LeBron, wala ata si Wade kanina. Siya na nagdalawahan. Siya na si LeBron, siya na si Wade. Tag-30 sila.
So, okay lang sa kanya yung mask niya na clear?
Ay, oo.
Do, alam mo, nainis nga ako sa NBA. Bakit?
Ganda nung ano.
Ang ganda na nung black mask eh.
Oo.
Oh. Kasi parang mukha talaga siyang Dark Knight eh.
Oo.
LeBron James.
Yan.
Diba? Oh. Honestly, hindi ko maintindihan why the NBA, hindi pa utos, request.
Request.
Oh. They requested LeBron, bro, pwede ba transparent na lang yung mask mo?
Meron pang naiinis na isa. Oh. Yung Charlotte.
Bakit?
Kasi nagpalit siya doon. 30 lang dapat gagawin.
Pero walang reason kung ba't nag-request
wala,
sila.
Walang there
wala
is no...
Wala pa atang definite na ano doon sa rulebook.
Oh, there's no clear reason why hindi pwedeng black yung carbon fiber na itim. Hmm. Kasi ginawa si Kobe nag-black mask, they requested na wag. So, nagpalit si Kobe.
Okay.
Si Kyrie Irving, same. The black, yung ginagamit ni Jvee, ganun. Yes, yung black na carbon fiber. So, hindi ko alam bakit the NBA, it's important for the NBA na transparent yung mask. I honestly don't know. You have any idea?
Baka, ano, maguguluhan yung tao pag suot ng layer.
Ano nga, nakagulo sa Twitter eh. Daming meme, ang daming ano, mukha yung mga Batman.
Pero mas pogi yung ano. Mas pogi
yung transparent?
Yung black.
Yung black kaya nga eh. Gustong-gusto ko yung black eh. Mas mukhang para superhero.
Bad.
Superhero yung
My name is Batman.
Ano? Batman. Ano nga eh?
Le Zorro.
Le Dark Knight. Le Batman. Oh, okay. And then, of course, the PBA Commissioner's Cup, as Richard mentioned, starts tomorrow. Mm-hmm. So, four teams will start their campaign.
Yes. Air 21 versus Global Port, first game.
Uy, ganda nun.
The defending champions, Alaska Aces, going up against Talking Text.
Two great games. I was actually in the Global Port practice this morning.
Mm-hmm.
So, ayun, nakausap ko si Coach Pinto. Nakausap po si Alex Cabagnon, mm-hmm. and I said hello to a lot of the players, and they're very excited, and it looks like as early as tomorrow, I think makikita na natin yung para bang gagawin yung magiging pido team yung
character
yung Global Port, no?
Yung kailangan mo makita, because Pido is a very character based guy,
right?
Kung matatranscend niya yung qualities niya, mm-hmm. to that team,
mm-hmm.
Now that's the first thing that we have to check out tomorrow.
No, because sabi ko, tinanong ko siya, are you going to change your coaching style? Sabi niya hindi.
Oo.
Kung paano siya mag-coach sa UST? Ganun din siya sa Global Port.
And so medyo kukwelyuhan rin niya yung mga player ng Global Port.
Ay, sabi niya hindi niya babaguhin, maganda kasi maraming bata na player.
Oo.
So obviously mga Eric Mink, mga hindi na mga Kabagnot.
Kasi
sino?
Sinabong.
Sinabong. Hindi, diba? Pero kunyari,
baka pumalag eh.
Si Terence, si RR, Nico, Justin Chua.
Ayun.
Alisin mga yan, parang sa mata ni Pido, mga bata pa yan, I think he can really apply the Pido style. No? I don't know about Kelly, pero si Kelly kinausap ko, sabi ko, hey Kel, sabi ko, is it true? Kasi naririnig ko na si Kelly Nabong, supposedly, marunong mag-MMA.
Okay.
Nag-aral daw ng MMA. Sabi niya, no, that's not true. I'm a nice guy.
Sabi niya?
Oo, sabi niya. Habang nakagamin yung... sabi niya, no, naka-smile siya. I'm a nice guy. Mm-hmm. I don't know MMA. And,
kasi dahil nga doon sa away nila ni Ping dati.
Yung ganun, no?
Oh, yung attempted na...
But yung Global Port, from what I was seeing sa practice sila kanina, and I'm not gonna reveal too much, no? Because... Okay. You know, when I watch a team, it's basically... It's
tsaka takot ka kay Kelly.
Tama. Tsaka kay Coach Pido.
Makwelyohan ka rin.
So, kasi baka na nung manunod yung L21, sa akin makakuha yung mga game plan. But, obviously, I think they're going to run. I think they'll utilize the outside shot, the three-point shot. I think it's going to look like yung UST team na, they'll go up and down the floor and they will want to score.
Ano yung kalaban na L21? Ano na rin? Tweak team na rin. Remember, no more KG Canaleta.
Yeah,
some new guys coming in.
Yeah,
and they might become a better team as well. And in the second game, maganda yun ah. Because you might say that both Talking Text and Alaska may have underachieved last conference.
True.
Dahil baka yung iba gusto nila umabot ng semis. Pero masige, apat lang talaga pwede sa semis eh.
Yeah.
So both teams, remember short conference.
Yes. So
yun ang masakit dyan.
Doon ako kinakabahan.
Ang bilis nito.
Doon ako kinakabahan.
Ano ba? Single round robin lang.
Nine games.
This is really fast. This will go fast.
Kaya nga eh, yung tendency namin to start slow, patay na kami. Pagka ganun, di ba? O kaya nga ngayon, sprint na kagad eh. From,
pabilisan.
Oo, 9 games. Pabilisan. Tapos dalawa yung ma-out.
Tapos ano, ano ba ang finals ba? 5 lang?
Best of 5, oh. Oo. Quarterfinals, 1 versus 8, 2 versus 7, twice to beat pa rin yung top 2 teams. Tapos 3-6, 4-5, best of 3. Tapos semifinals,
same
best
setup.
Of 5. Wow. Yes, best of 5 rin na ano. So makes it.
Yeah, so that's happening tomorrow. So dapat, first day pa lang, you know, tutukan nyo na. You know,
mga start, import. Mga import.
And then mga import also. Start following the games because it's gonna be real quick and it happens tomorrow. Now, another thing that will start tomorrow will be the UAAP Finals Women's Volleyball. Ateneo
exciting.
Versus LaSalle.
Exciting.
Okay.
May konting disadvantage ang Ateneo.
Konti lang naman, slight lang. No? Tries to beat yung LaSalle.
Tries to beat.
And they're undefeated. So
actually, they lost one set.
One set.
One season, no?
Or so, we'll discuss that. You know, volleyball and Ateneo
yeah,
LaSalle.
Yeah, okay, volleyball.
We'll have a live interview also with Dzi Gervacio. All coming up here on The Bro Show after this.
Hi guys, it's me, Tita K. Tita K! Come and hang out on Live Love Lols. Let's talk about makeup, beauty.
Hi, ganda.
Who's that? We can talk about ugly too. Nah, just kidding. And of course, Donya Problems Galore. Yaya, ang spaceship, paki-on. Fashion, shopping. Oh my god, shopping! I love shopping! Ah! Food! We gotta talk about food. Anything and everything on cyberspace. Let's buy everything. We can talk about glamour and ubusan ng glamour. We fly Wednesday 6 to 7 p.m. only on nmfnetwork.tv.
And now back to the Bro Show.
All right, welcome back, bros, babes, and sponkies. Habang si Mico is looking for a phone, pal. Ito, pag-uusapan na nga natin is UAAP volleyball. Baka sabi niyo, ano ba concern ng bros sa volleyball? Eh? Women's volleyball pa to, di ba? Pero ako, very entertaining itong
Hi, are you ready?
To, ikaw, interesado ko ba?
Okay, hold on.
Sport pa rin siya. That's why mga bros always become interested with it. Tapos, sport na siya, tapos ang dami pang mga babes na naglalaro.
Yun.
Plus, the same passion na nakikita mo in other sports.
Yes,
it's the same passion that transcends with yung mga ito, mga players. Lalo na sa women's. Ha? Mas, pagtitingnan natin, mas pinapanood ng bagya yung women's kaysa doon sa men's. Eh. Pagdating doon sa volleyball.
Without a doubt, I mean, the women players sa UAP, they're bigger stars.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, they're rock stars.
May mga commercial na sila.
They have endorsements and like, you know, I hear that
players... Buto
pa sila. Darating tayo dyan. And you know, I hear that yung players, you know, they have a hard time getting out of, let's say, kunyari, the arena or MOA because ang daming nag-aabang sa labas to get their autographs, to have pictures taken with them. I mean, they're really college rock stars.
Yeah, that's right. And yun ang masaya doon, no? Kasi para bang hindi, walang monopoly ang basketball. There's another sport on the rise. In terms of popularity, and you can see the packed arenas, and even TV ratings are good. So talagang very interested dito nga sa volleyball.
And we're happy for the girls.
Yeah.
I mean, and hindi lahat kasi ng college athlete will get that kind of TV exposure,
yes.
recognition, you know, the followers on Twitter and on Instagram. Yeah. And it's just getting bigger and bigger, and especially because, like, you know, starting tomorrow, we'll have the finals of the women's volleyball, and it's Ateneo versus LaSalle. Now, to help us, give all of you a preview of the finals, we have someone who used to play for Ateneo and one of the more popular players that played for the Lady Eagles. We have, ito favorite ko to mag-serve. Oh, power serve to eh. Power serve.
Okay.
Parang racket kung mag-serve.
Ah, talaga?
It's a personal thrill for me that we're going to talk live on the Bro Show hotline, Miss Dzi Gervacio, former Lady Eagle. Hi, Dzi.
Hi, guys.
Hello. There you go. Okay. We're just fixing the volume. Yeah. Yes.
Good.
Can you hear us well?
What? Sorry.
Can you hear us?
Yep.
Okay. Zia, Mico here with Richard and Jason. And, you know, Z, forgive us, though. We're not exactly like super diehard volleyball fans. I mean, we're more associated with basketball.
Yes.
But every time we get to watch a volleyball match, it's really exciting stuff. I mean, it's great TV.
Zee, why is volleyball so popular now among Filipino sports fans?
I guess it started out few years back when, like, media started covering volleyball games. I guess it started with UAAP, pakonti-konti. Tapos, and then Shakey's V-League, the commercial leagues, started broadcasting the games as well. So a lot of people were able to catch a glimpse of how it is, how volleyball is played. So eventually, parang nagustuhan na naman nila. So I guess, kaya yun.
How big a thrill is it for you? Kasi sabi mo nga, di ba, when you started, maybe your first year with Ateneo, very, very little pa lang yung mga nanonood. But when you graduated, was it last year? Puno na yung stands when you were playing. How big a thrill was it for you to see it from that stage all the way to what it is right now?
What's that? I'm sorry.
You were witness to how small it was before compared to what it is now. How big a thrill is it for you to actually see that volleyball, eto na, it's on the map and people are actually lining up and scrambling for tickets?
Well, I'm very happy for the sport itself because, yun nga, parang nag-start kami, yung batchmates ko, as in, parang walang tao yung venue every time we play. Tapos, and then, at time na we graduated, a lot of people were watching her. Yun nga, tapos, we didn't expect na we're gonna play or be part of the Coliseum. Yeah, it's very hard to something. Sobrang nakakataba na puso na ma-witness namin yung development ng
Well, Zee, of course, tomorrow, no, yung finals nga, Ateneo versus Lasal, and I'm sure, because it's Ateneo versus Lasal, eh, talagang lalong magiging popular ang women's volleyball, and there's going to be a lot of attention in this finals game. What do you expect tomorrow, dyan sa finals game of Ateneo versus Lasal?
Well, I expect na sobrang iingay sa venue. Sobrang, I'm expecting na a lot of people are gonna watch. I expect, you know, yung rivalry essence ng Ateneo Lasal would be very evident from the game.
Okay, well, Lasal of course has that overwhelming edge. May chance bang Ateneo, Zee? I mean, may chance bang Lady Eagles with a thrice to beat disadvantage and then, you know, nobody seems to know how to beat this LaSalle team.
Hello.
Zee?
Sorry.
Can you hear us?
Sorry, it's kind of choppy.
Yeah. Okay, can you hear us now?
Hello?
Yeah, can you hear us?
Wait, hello?
Okay, well, you know what? We'll try and call again. Okay, yeah. we'll get Dzi Gervacio on the line again. We'll just do a redial on the phone. But, you know, you can't help but be happy. I mean, I know, like, for Ateneo, they've had a hard time trying to beat LaSalle year after year after year. But at the same time, you're part of this really popular sport, and nothing can remove nothing can change the fact na lahat sila sumisikat.
Are we talking about basketball or
volleyball? Volleyball.
Kasi I'm having a hard time beating LaSalle year after year after year. Yeah, kala ko basketball pinag-uusapan.
Yeah, dati, you were having a hard time beating Ateneo year after year after year after year after year.
Namin, no?
Okay. So, no, but you know, yung volleyball, I mean, it must be such a thrill for these girls na they're finally experiencing what the guys have always experienced, basketball.
Yes, parang before kasi, during the time, I can relate to what Z was saying na dati walang tao sa venues and pag nanonood sila before ng basketball game, parang nakakaingit, bakit sila may attention, bakit kami wala? Yeah. But right now, they're receiving the same kind of attention. Sabi mo nga, para silang rock stars in a venue, ang dami nilang followers, nagkakaroon sila ng endorsements ngayon. So, it's really an exciting time to be part of that dahil kasama ka dun sa pag-boom ng sport .
That's right.
Nandun yung part, you're part of history. And yung mga past players, parang sayang, sana nung panahon namin, ganyan rin. So, you know, if I were a player, ako, I would just really cherish it and try to document it as much as possible.
Oh, yeah. And, well, everything's documented because of social media. I think we have Dzi Gervacio back on the line. Dzi?
Yes.
Okay, Dzi, can you give us like a preview for game one between Ateneo and LaSalle? I mean, Lady Eagles, meron bang chance ang Lady Eagles to make a series out of this?
I'm expecting that they're gonna put up a fight, at least better than the one they did during the first two rounds of the elimination rounds. Kasi I've noticed parang the team has been peaking in their game. So yeah, I'm expecting na kahit pa paano may laban this Wednesday, and hoping that ma-extend nila yung game to Wednesday next week.
Thrice to beat. I mean, it's almost unprecedented, or it doesn't happen often to actually have that for a team to have a three-game advantage and still lose. How can you say, like, we peak na yung Lady Eagles, but is that even doable with that setup?
What's that?
Is a thrice to beat advantage doable? I mean, in reality.
Well, I guess the ladies just have to keep in mind na one game at a time. I mean, we kind of had a step closer last season 74 kasi threat din yun eh. Tapos we won game one, but then the succeeding two games, we lost. So I guess kaya naman siya, but then, yun nga, parang siguro it's really the will to win that's gonna bring them all the way through the finals.
Well, finally, Zee, can you just give our bros a chance to find out ano ba yung strength ng Ateneo, ano ba yung strength ng Lasal, so that when they watch the game, they actually know. Ah, ito pala yung sinasabi ni Zee na ito yung strength ng Lasal, ito yung strength ng Ateneo.
Well, first of all, as in mapapansin mo talaga sa Lasal side, sobrang lakas ng blocking nila, because they're a really tall team. I mean, since we've started siguro volleyball, parang sila na yung one of the teams that are matatangkad. So we're expecting na they're gonna be all up in there blocking every hit that we're gonna make. Tapos in contrast to that, I think yung Ateneo naman has the edge of receiving the ball or digging the ball. Kasi yun na, parang it's the defense to the blocking of Lasal that we have to expect from the Lady Eagles.
Well, Zee, based on your knowledge, ha, dahil ba sa sikat na sikat na ang volleyball ngayon, yung mga players ba, dumami ba yung mga manliligaw nila? Or yung mga shooters? Diba? Hindi na ba pinapansin? Ngayon, pansin na eh. Dumami ba?
Yung mga manliligaw.
Yeah, oo. Oh,
kasi sikat na eh.
Oh yeah, syempre parang pila-pila na yung iba dyan.
Wow, pila-pila.
Wow. Stalker
lalo
na.
Lalo na yung iba.
No, but like sa social media, yung dramatically ba lumaki yung number of followers nyo on Twitter or on Instagram, and because of volleyball?
What's that?
Dumami ba yung followers nyo? I mean, did you notice big increase?
As in, ang laking bagay nung media din kasi. Like, yun nga, I've mentioned earlier na yung TV coverage has been a big thing.
Yeah.
Has been a big factor in the, in showing the world, at least the Philippines, how it is yung, collegiate volleyball dito sa,
Okay. Hey, one of these days, Zee, sana you can drop by here on the Bro Show.
Next time.
All right, thanks, Zee, for helping us out.
Thank you.
Thank you.
All right, that's Zee Gervacio, former Lady Eagle. Actually, part of that legendary group of Lady Eagles, because they put Ateneo Volleyball on the map. Mm-hmm. Now that they've graduated, kaya bata tong team ngayon eh. Mm-hmm. Kasi nga nawala yung veterans. And then si Eliza Valdez lang yung naiwan. Mm-hmm. And then si Denden Lazaro, and Zee was mentioning, magaling yung Ateneo sa pag-receive and pag-dig. That's basically then Lazaro. Offense coming from Eliza Valdez. Sa Lasal naman, they have Abby Maranyo, who I still refer to as the Mark Pingris of volleyball. Kasi tapang talaga. And then Mika Reyes naman yung matangkad nila. So, that should be a fun series. I hope it's a long series.
Well, at least mga 5 sets.
So, good luck to Ateneo Lasal in the women's volleyball finals. Okay, we'll take a short break. When we return, we'll check the PBA Instagram accounts.
Yes.
Yung mga Instagram accounts of your favorite players.
We'll try to see if we can have a
Coach
match.
Yeah, oh. With Coach Norman. Hopefully, we get to do that when we return.
What do you think is ailing local football?
Well, politics.
Should athletes be endorsers?
Yes, why not?
Why did you refuse to be the Haskell's head coach countless times?
I've been there, done that. Too much politics, like I said. Like I posted one time a few days ago, coaching is a thankless job. With what's happening with Michael Weiss, we talked about it already before, personally, one-on-one, and I said, it happens. And I said, you should know that because you worked also somewhere in other countries as well. There's no such thing as a permanent job in coaching, in any sport.
Why do you say thankless?
Well, you're only as good as the wins.
And then that's it.
Plus, of course, there are other factors like disrespect, honor, honesty, and all of this. Because you're just a coach, you're not the manager. You're not the association, you're not the institution. So you, as a coach, you're just an employee. So you're as good only as the wins that you have.
And now back to the Bro Show.
Okay, we mentioned earlier that the PBA Commissioner's Cup starts tomorrow, mm-hmm. Wednesday.
Haba ng break eh.
Oo nga eh.
Buti nga kayo, nag-break
na ako. Di ba kayo laro-laro na kayo?
Ako hindi pa ako nag-break eh.
Aren't you guys excited to play?
Ay grabe, oo, miss na namin ang basketball.
Okay, so the teams that are opening the Commissioner's Cup in the first game, it's Air 21 against Global Port. In the second game, it's Alaska versus Talk and Text.
Yes.
And because Talking Text is playing in the first game, we have no less than Talking Text head coach, Mr. 100%, Coach Norman Black, live on the Bro Show Hotline. Hello, Coach Norman.
Hello, Mix. Hi, Richard. How are you? Masa kayo?
Coach, why are you? Hi, Coach. Remember me?
It's Blacksboard and the eraser.
Blacksboard? The eraser. Coach, do you remember Blacksboard?
Yeah, I have faint memories of Blacksboard.
Okay, Coach, you're starting your campaign in the Commissioner's Cup tomorrow. What can fans expect from Talking Text? You know, especially since, you know, you lost to what team did you lose to, Coach? Was it Sandy Coffey and Coach Richard?
Yes, we lost to Coach Richard. Oh, congratulations, Coach Richard, for your
choice. Oh, you know.
Thank you very much, Coach. You sound really, you know, very sincere.
Padala mo ng t-shirt.
I'll say Richard has a lot of bonus now.
I'll send you a shirt, Coach.
Coach, what can fans expect from Talking Text in the Commissioner's Cup?
Well, we just want to do better, Mico, than we did last conference. We want to be in better condition, want to play better defense, better offense. I think this will be a much better conference for us. The focus is really there. We still have a couple of injuries to key players, but we'll just have to gut that out for the time being. Our import is solid, if not spectacular, but he's okay. He's a good rebounder, he's strong inside. So we're just hoping for a much better conference.
Coach, Ali Peak retiring over the weekend, around that area. How will that affect the team?
I couldn't hear you. Could you say to ask the question again, please?
Coach Jason here. Ali Peak retired a few days ago. And how's that going to affect the team in terms of what you're trying to do, and as well as the morale?
That's a big blow for us, Ali going down. But if you remember, Ali has not really been with us much this year so far. So we were able to pick up Rob Reyes during the off season, and he's been on the injured list most of the season, on the inactive list. So we just activated him to take Ali Peak's place. And Ali will be a big loss for us, but you know, that's basketball. Ali played for 16 years, and just like all of us, we have to retire at some point. So
yeah,
I would just have to move on.
Coach, talking about your import, are there any weaknesses that we can exploit?
I'm not gonna tell you.
Ano ba yung tanong mo, bro?
Ang dami naman, masyado obvious eh.
Anong tanong mo?
Why will Coach Norman answer your question?
To help me out.
You have to scout like everybody else, Richard. Do your job.
Okay, Coach. Coach Jvee Casio.
He's a perimeter player, Richard. He's an inside player.
Okay.
Mostly around the basket. I think he's good up to about 15 feet, maybe. And he's pretty strong. That's basically what it comes down to. His strength would probably be rebounding, the natural rebounder. So we're hoping to utilize that to our advantage.
Okay. Coach Jvee Casio is also part of your coaching staff now, Coach, right?
Yes, that's correct. Yes.
Now, how is he fitting in your system, your team? What's his role now?
People don't realize it, but John actually started out with me many years ago. Yes. We won't say what year, but I was actually his first head coach in the PBA in San Miguel, and it's nice to be with him again. He brings a lot of knowledge and experience to the game to help us, and we haven't assigned any one responsibility to him yet, but you know, he can help in all areas, so I'm trying to keep it open as possible.
You know, I will reveal Coach Jong's role on Toketex. Because I was in practice earlier. Coach Norman, wasn't I in your practice this morning, today?
Yes, you were. Yes.
Yes, I was. And I already saw what Coach Jong will do.
What?
He was shooting.
Huh?
He's going to play.
What?
Coach Jong is going to play. Because I saw him, he was warming up and sinking 3-point shots.
Nakatak in. Sigurado nakatak in.
Oh, nakatak in.
That, but I don't know whether we want Coach Jong back to play. I'd rather use him as a coach.
Coach, one more question. All these preparations, I'm sure you're very busy right now because you have a game tomorrow. How is this going to affect your following of their favorite telenovela? Coach?
Mosso Talaga.
Take a sandali.
What?
Richard, what is this telenovela? I don't know what telenovela you're talking about.
But you have to be careful, with my heart, huh? Be careful with my heart. Right, Coach?
Well, I'm comment.
Coach Norman has no comment. You know why?
Why?
He stopped watching.
Why?
You have to ask Coach Norman why he's no longer watching Be
why,
Careful
Coach?
With My Heart.
What happened? Why?
No, Mico, huh?
Well, anyway, Coach.
Show me if I tell you.
Don't worry, Coach. It's just you and the three of us. No one else will know. It's just the three of. It's just the four of us talking. Don't worry. Coach, good luck. Good luck tomorrow, and good luck in the Commissioner's Cup.
And good health, you know, talking text.
Okay, guys. Maraming salamat. Appreciate it.
Thanks, Coach.
Thanks, Thank Coach.
See you games. Richard.
Yes.
Behave, okay?
Of course, Coach. I take after you. You're my model.
Thank you, Coach Norman. Good luck tomorrow.
All right. Maraming salamat, guys.
All right.
You know, yung talking text, isa sa pinakakawawa sa injuries, no?
You know, I was talking to Ryan Reyes earlier. And
injured
I said,
na naman?
No, he's healthy.
Uy, talaga?
I sabi ko, Ryan, please stay healthy.
Yeah.
Kasi, you know, I mean, sayang naman kung di natin napapanood si Ryan Reyes. And sabi ko, I miss it when people don't get hurt because you're not there. He's out there hurting people, di ba? Sayang eh. No, sabi ko, and I sincerely said, Ryan, please stay healthy, so that you can continue playing.
That was a big factor, when we played Talk and Text. In the 100% si Ryan.
So
helped us in our series.
I mean, and honestly,
he hasn't been 100% for a while.
Parang may Samboy Lim syndrome because and this is in all honesty, regardless what teams players play for. We don't like it pag yung mga players, and especially the talented ones, hindi sila makalaro parate.
That's right.
Kasi because of constant injuries. Because,
they rob us of watching good players.
Yeah, and even their fans, they get frustrated because hindi nila nakikita every game.
Sana yung mga bangko na lang.
Hindi rin, hindi. We don't want injuries, period. Oh, okay? We don't like that. We don't. And honestly, we don't even wish it. Kahit na may mga player kunyari, hindi namin gusto. We don't wish.
Meron kang mga player na hindi mo gusto. Sino yun?
Wala. If lang. Now, we don't wish that on players. Okay. All right. So that was Coach Norman. And kalaban nila, Alaska. So we'll talk to somebody from Alaska. Pero talk about, let's call our next interview first. In the meantime,
busy ka naman. Oh, busy ka, unli ka.
Bakit phone ko lang lagi? O mag-usap muna kayo diyan, tatawagan ko lang.
In Alaska, defending champions and
pero hindi bringing... sila nag-dozier dahil maliit eh, di ba?
Hindi, dozier sila.
Ah, dozier sila. Alam ko hindi sila magdo-dozier.
Pero si Dozier, I think, after that championship, no, medyo tumangkad. Stopped playing. He stopped playing for a while. And then, parang 10 months yata of inactivity. Something like that. I'm not even sure. Pero yun lang na nabasa ko. No? Pero right now, I think he's in good shape already. Nag-Cebu tournament sila. And then, invitational, nanalo sila doon. Which they did last year. So ngayon, they're feeling good about themselves and they're raring to defend the crown.
And you know, when you're defending the crown and you have the same import back, ang laking bagay.
Ay, oo.
Oo, kasi meron yung, lalo na short tournament ha, yes. Kasi magkakakilala na lahat.
Mm-hmm. Laki advantage sila kasi iba, unang-unam, ano
di
pa?
Alam.
Ano pa, pakiramdaman pa with the import, it is yes, a single round robin lang. So yes. There's not enough time for chemistry, kaya... Okay, Alaska with that advantage because they have a lot of familiar faces and a familiar system. And they have Jvee Casio, who is live on the Bro Show Hotline. Hi, Jvee.
Hi, sir. Hello. Thank you. Thank you for na-invite niya ako sa pagiging bro.
Yeah. Bro, hindi boses player si Jvee.
Ano, boses ano?
Parang ano lang eh. Parang hindi makakasakit sa kabilang team eh.
Akala mo lang yun.
Lang hindi naman siya nananakit eh. Hindi nananakit na alam
hindi,
mo.
Hindi, sabihin sa puntos.
Sa puntos lang nananakit yan eh.
Jvee, kamusta ang Alaska? We heard na you know you had a very good stint sa Cebu. Tama ba?
Yes. We won the pocket tournament and it gives us yung confidence kahit pa paano. Kasi coming from the conference last conference, medyo kailangan din namin ng mga ganong confidence boost.
Jvee, nung last conference, parang napansin namin yung nawala lang yung consistency. Kasi parang nandun na kayo lagi in every game, pero yung breaks never went your way. How do you guys plan to turn things around this conference?
Well, siguro it starts with, yun nga, nakawa rin na ulit namin si Dozier and bigay rin ng leave sa mga players kahit paano. Pero it really comes on the game eh. Kung depende ang ano namin, yung... flow namin, especially kung coming crunch time, sabi nyo nga, tikit nga kami sa mga games namin, pero pinakapos. Medyo unfamiliar place sa amin yung last conference, probably last two conference. Pero yun nga, we have to wake up and parang finish the game stronger.
Well, Jvee, talking about Dozier, no? I don't know, correct me if I'm wrong, pero parang nagkaroon siya ng matagal na inactivity from playing basketball, totoo ba yun? And how is he now? Do you think, in your opinion, is he better... now than he was last year?
Well, I think depende sa games, malalaman natin. Because malaking bagay rin mawala sa, I think, sa playing shape ng 10 months. Pero his body, his work ethic, parang parehas lang eh. Ganun pa rin eh. Maganda pa rin yung pangatawan and the way he plays, medyo ganun pa rin. Pero I think may mga in-improve rin siya. Medyo secret muna ngayon. Para hindi na...
Ba?
Wala secret.
That's what... Ace in the hole. Huh? May ace in the hole sila.
Hindi.
Kasi andito ka, bro. Eh. Kung wala si Richard dito, sasabihin sana sa amin ni Jvee.
Hindi, okay lang naman ako eh. Hindi naman ako magsasa... Hindi naman ako...
Kailan niya ba kalaban Alaska? Baka matagal pa.
Tagal pa. Ano? Ewan ko.
Hindi ko alam. Nagsasalita si Jvee, parang alam mo na nakangiti. Tapos kita yun.
Ganun si Jvee. Kahit sa Instagram, laging nakangiti.
Kahit sinusutang ka ng tres, tapos pagpantalo sa kalaban, nakangiti lang eh.
Jvee, anong, meron ba kayo, anong gagawin yung iba in this tournament? Because, you know, just like Talk and Text, I think it's fair to say na hindi nyo na-achieve yung goals nyo no, in the Philippine Cup. So, anong gagawin yung iba dito sa Commissioner's Cup?
Well, I think, maybe try to be better, more siguro. Sa, kasi yung focusing on the last conference, masama talaga. Parang we just want to get the fire back. Like, try to be competitive again in the championship caliber. Kasi yun talaga yung gusto namin as a team, na magawa ulit namin yun.
You mean to say after na-eliminate kayo, pinagsama-sama ba kayo ni Coach Luigi, pinagtipon kayo and said na hey, we have to bounce back because Alaska is one of the better teams. I mean, there's a lot of good teams and you might say there's about six teams that are up there in the upper echelon of the league and Alaska is one of them. Ano yung ginawa niya during the off season to you know, it's almost the same na parang because I can't actually put a finger kung ano yung nangyari sa Alaska because they're there. They just
edi tanong natin kay Jvee.
Oh, tanong natin.
Jvee, ano nga ba nangyari in the Philippine Cup because marami nagtataka why hindi umabot ng dulo yung Alaska.
Well, tingin ko lang unfamiliar place sa amin. Yung nangyari, we have so many close games and breaks hindi napunta sa amin and nagkapatong-patong and until yun nga hanggang sa na ano kami sa last mga yung eliminated games. Pero I think yung elimination game we responded very well. Fortunately, kinapos lang talaga kasi it's really a tough situation for us.
Ito magandang tanong.
Ano?
Pag sa practice ba si Calvin na nakukulitan rin kayo sa kanya?
pag si
Calvin pa nagsi-scrimmage kayo, nagkakainitan rin, inaano rin kayo? Inaasar rin kayo ni Calvin sa ensayo?
Ay, ano ko? Calvin, kung paano yung sa court, ganun rin sa game.
Sa ensayo? Pati sa ensayo?
Very competitive. Lang
talaga. Okay, competitive talaga si Calvin.
Kita mo naman.
Kaya, we have to admire that. And, talagang laro. And ano, nakikita ko, gusto niya mag-improve, yung willing to learn, and ganun. Kaya, okay si Calvin.
So JV, ano ba talaga yung sikreto ni ano ngayon, Dozier? Kasi April 20 pa naman tayo maglalaban eh. Last game elimination.
Ano naman masabihin ba eh?
Hello, sir.
Hello, April 20 pa tayo maglalaban, JV. Baka gusto mo na i-share yung secret ni Rob Dozier.
Medyo may... Sorry, sir. Medyo hindi ko na...
Hindi mo na di direct.
Style. Thailand ka. Hindi ko sagutin.
Okay, Jvee, can you hear us?
Yes.
Yan. Sige, Jvee, ano, baka may message ka to all the...
Automatic
ano,
yan.
Alaska fans. Kasi, na-miss ka rin nila yung Alaska because natanggal kayo eh. So, your message for all the Alaska fans watching the Bro Show.
Hello, sa lahat ng Gatas Republic, supportan niyo kami bukas sa game against Southern Texas to start up the conference. We'll do our best na regain natin yung championship para sa inyo. So, thank you.
Okay. All right. Ako si Jvee Casio.
Pasan na
best player.
Ito kunyari, Jason as Jvee Casio. Jvee, anong message mo sa fans?
Una, I'd like to thank the alumni of San Beda and the alumni ng LaSalle for all the support and the prayers. And of course, yung Gatas Republic, thank you very much. Yung family ko na
si Jackie.
Saka si Jackie, thank you very much. Yun nga, alumni, thank you very much.
Kuha ba, Jvee?
May kulang pa ba?
Oo, kuha na lahat. Hindi ko na kailangan.
Jvee, salamat bro.
Good luck.
Salamat and see you sa game.
Alright, Jvee Casio of the Alaska Aces live on the Bro Show Hotline. Pagkausap mo si Jvee, para sa Kristen lang ang dating eh. No? Mabait eh.
Rank mo nga si Jvee sa ano? Point guards.
Si Jvee? Wow. Top 10.
Eh, 10 lang naman yung team eh.
Ilan ba? Kaya nga lang sa top 10.
Safe naman nun.
Oo.
Kasi ang dami na magagaling talaga.
Maraming
na point guard.
Ako nga, if anyone asks me to rank the point guards, ayoko. It's hard. Ang dami.
Oo.
I mean...
Sige, center na lang.
Junmar number one. Okay, so again, good luck to all the teams. We talked to Jvee Casio of Alaska. We talked to Coach Norman of Talking Text. And good luck to all the teams, including Sammy Coffey, who will compete in the Commissioner's Cup. We'll take a short break. We'll have our last segment here on The Bro Show after this.
Hi. They say nothing in this world is free. And for the most part, that's true. But here at NMF Network, all shows are indeed 100% free. And as an added feature, you have the option to subscribe to all your favorite programs, also at no charge. Why should you subscribe? By subscribing, you no longer have the hassle of delays when you stream the program. You also don't need to keep checking our site to see if your favorite programs are up because they'll automatically be uploaded to your device as soon as it's available. Here's how to do it. For those people with Apple mobile devices, first you need to download the podcast app. Once you download the podcast app, open it, and you should be taken to the featured page. Now, you look for the store button. Hit the store button, and after doing that, hit the search button. Put your cursor on it and type New Media Factory. All our shows should automatically appear. Pick your favorite or favorites. Open it and hit subscribe. And that's it. You're done. Congratulations and welcome to the New Media Factory family.
And now back to the Bro Show.
In our last segment here on this week's Bro Show, we'll check the best of the Instagram.
Mm-hmm.
Instagram of PBA players.
Yes, pero wag naman pictures kasi lagi tayong pictures.
Oh, video naman tayo.
Oh, video tayo.
Wait, video.
Ay, huwag kang mag-alala. Okay to.
Okay.
Talagang general patronage for the family pareho.
Wholesome.
Video na ano.
Hindi, for the family to. Okay, so anong sumunahin?
Yung kay ano na lang, kay Cash.
Okay, Cash. Okay, so this was actually, I think, originally posted by Lay Norwood, yes. Wife, the beautiful wife of Gabe. And then, pinost ni Gabe, and then nilagay ko sa vlog ko. And daming nanonood eh. Now, this was a video of his of Gabe's son, si Cash Norwood. And then, nag-ano siya, parang Barker.
Oo.
In-announced yung starting lineup ng Rain or Shine.
Wow.
Okay, and so many people have seen this, and just in case niyo pa nakikita, we want to share it with all of you because, trust me, it will make you smile. Watch this.
I'm going to go over.
Pero, cute talaga.
Pwede pang ano, bro, gawa kayo, pero siga ako. Sige na, sa ensayo bukas, gawin mo.
Gagawa kami.
Oh, pero ganun.
Oh, sige,
James,
sige.
Yop.
Oh, sige, sige, oh, sure.
Ayan, yeah. Para meron din yung San Mi Coffee, meron yung
panapat,
Rain or Shine.
Pantapat.
Eh, cute yung sa Rain or Shine eh.
Kaya nga, si Jerwin nga pantapat, di ba? Cute, tapos ano, horror.
Hindi, ako may pantapat na ako ngayon pa lang.
Ngayon na?
Pero hindi parang Barker. Ano? Ito, meme. Ay, hindi pala meme to.
Ano to? Video meme?
Ano to?
Video meme?
Basta meron kaming alaga sa San Mi Coffee.
Ito ba yung gumagalan?
Oo, yung defensive player of the year
nila. Ginagaya ito yung free throw ni James Yap. Ha? Binidyo namin siya. Ito, tignan nyo.
James Yap free throw, Maning version.
Wow, si Maning.
Oh, yan yung alaga namin.
Sikat na si Maning eh.
Ay, Jesus Mario Sep, talaga. Oh, ano, kita mo, yung pati yung buhok.
Ba't siya nagpa-blind?
Ewan ko doon. Ewan ko nga eh. Kung natalo kami, sisihin pa namin. Oo, oh, sisihin pa namin. Pasalamat siya, nanalo kami. Pero kita mo yung pagka-sick ng legs niya. Ha? Yung pag si James, yung nag-free throw ring na gano'n. Tsaka ano lang yan, ha? Two takes
oh, na shoot kasi, niya agad.
No, hindi na-shoot yung una eh.
Pero, but okay, those are wondering, and if Maning looks familiar, he's that guy na laging stay low. Sa bench. Hindi ba naiilang sa akin si Coach Tim?
Hindi, pinagsabihan namin yan game 6.
Oh.
Basta nandun na, eh, nakaupo kami nila Coach Tim. Eh, talaga lumpas sa dito eh. Maning, go back. Eh, sorry coach.
Pero bakit hindi siya
na... rin siya pa.
Bakit hindi siya natatawagan ng ano?
Oh, ano, bench improper decorum. Bench decorum.
And mukhang na-entertain rin sila commissioner sa kanya.
No, because he does it the whole game.
Oh,
siya lang ang pinapatayo ng buong PBA.
He does it the whole game.
Yes.
Stay low. Ano sinin mga sinisigaw niya?
Stay low. Yun lang.
Si Opensa, stay low.
Uy, ating bola.
Ano siya? What is his actual...
Let's get it on.
Ano yung actual position niya sa team?
Designation.
Paul Boy. Utility.
Ball boy lab.
Taper siya.
Taper.
All around yan si Maning.
All around.
Taper, nagmamasahe rin, nagre-referee rin. Yun, minsan, nagko-coach.
Can we have Maning on the Bro Show?
Sure. Oh.
Let's have Maning on the Bro Show one of these days.
Sige, boxing yan. Former boxer
yan. Dahil yung mga player, di mo madala. Ball boy na lang.
Sige. Sige,
okay.
Sige. Sige, nandali lang si Maning.
Oh, sige, pampa good vibes, one more. Huwag na yung kay Maning. Yung kay Cashnor, one more. Oh. Pang good vibes.
Okay, boy, boy! I don't still go over. Yes, Dad! I'll go over. Oh, I know ya! Skull ball of free poly! Bubble.
Purito ko doon. Di ba lahat lively siya? Pero parang pagdating kay Bo Belga, intimidated siya. Bo Belga.
Isa pa kaya.
Bo Belga. Yun na. Gabe Norwood! Bully!
Yung awan niya.
Bo Belga. Baka magalit eh.
So we'd like to thank all the bros for... Announcement.
The Bro Show for
is
the podcast need? As well as the Bro Show...
The radio show. On 99.5 Play FM.
Yes. Yeah. Is in need of interns. Kailangan lang naman, madali lang naman ang requirements. Kailangan maganda, sexy, single.
At bata.
At hindi magsusumbong. Seriously. If you're interested in the field of media and you'd like to learn, and you'd like to learn from the bros, most especially, send us an email through thebroshowph@gmail.com. Send us your resumes, and we'll try to accommodate as many as we can.
As many as
possible. We hope to be able to help each other. Now, you know, yung, ano,
we get to teach.
One way or another. And that's it.
And then just one more announcement from the New Media Factory. You can now get the iPad Mini with Retina display and iPad Air on installment basis at Beyond the Box. Just check out Beyond the Box on Twitter. That's at Beyond the Box PH. Or go to Beyond the Box here in one Rockwell.
Oh, tsaka follow the Bro Show on Twitter. Okay? Bro Show NF.
Okay.
Bro Show. So, nagpapabati pala Warren. Yeah. Coach Warren, kapitan. Lagi siyang nanonood.
Ah, si Warren nanonood.
Okay, for Jason, Richard, I'm Mico. Thanks, bros.
Bye.
Thanks for watching the Bro Show, bro.
The views and opinions expressed on any program are those of the persons appearing on the program and do not necessarily reflect the views and opinions of the New Media Factory. Some programs on this network might include strong images and language and may not be suitable for all audiences. Viewer discretion is advised.